Good day! Welcome to Math Husay Math 9 tutorial. In this lesson, you will learn how to characterize the roots of a quadratic equation using the discriminant. Let's begin. Let's recall that the roots of quadratic equation ax squared plus bx plus c are given by the quadratic formula x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. We can see that the radicand b squared minus 4ac determines the nature of these roots. So let's analyze the different possible values of the discriminant. Consider the equation ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. If the discriminant b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are real, rational, and equal. If the discriminant b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0 and is a perfect square, the roots are real, rational, and unequal. If b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0 but this time not the perfect square, the roots can be described as real, irrational, and unequal. And lastly, if the discriminant b squared minus 4ac is less than 0, then the equation ax squared plus bx equals 0 has no solution. Let's take these examples. Number 1, determine the nature of the roots of x squared minus 4x plus 4 equals 0. We have to identify the values of a, b, and c. And in this case, we know that a is 1, b is negative 4, and c is positive 4. Now, we will substitute these values into the discriminant, which is b squared minus 4ac. Now, substituting these values, we have negative 4 squared minus 4 times 1 times 4. Now, we know that negative 4 squared is 16. And we also know that negative 4 times 1 times 4 will give you negative 16. Now, as you can see, 16 minus 16 is 0. Therefore, the discriminant b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0. Now, we can describe the nature of the roots of x squared minus 4x plus 4 equals 0 as real, rational, and equal. We say that it's real, rational, and equal by factoring this equation. As you can see, x squared minus 4x plus 4 equals 0 can be factored as the quantity of x minus 2 squared equals 0 because that is a perfect square trinomial, right? So, if you look for the value of x, you will have x is equal to 2 and you have two values which is actually the same. X is still equal to 2. So, in this case, we know that the roots are real, it's rational, and it's equal. So again, if the discriminant is equal to 0, then the nature of roots are real, rational, and equal. Let's take example number 2. Determine the nature of the roots of x squared plus 7x plus 10 equals 0. Again, we identify the values of a, b, and c, which is 1, positive 7, and positive 10 for a, b, and c respectively. Now again, distributing it to the discriminant formula, then we have b squared minus 4ac. So substituting these values, you will have 7 squared minus 4 times 1 times 10. Now we know that 7 squared is 49. We also know that negative 4 times 1 times 10 will give you negative 40. So we subtract 40 from 49 and you will have a squared minus 4ac equals 9. And this time the discriminant is greater than 0 and we have 9 as a perfect square number. So we can describe the nature of the roots of x squared plus 7x plus 10 equals 0 as real, rational, and unequal. So let me show you the roots. So by factoring again, x squared plus 7x plus 10 equals 0, it can be factored as the quantity of x plus 2 times the quantity of x plus 5 equals 0. Now when you solve for x, you will have x is equal to negative 5 or x is equal to negative 2. Now in this case, we have these two roots, two solutions. These are real, these are rational, and we see that these two values are unequal. So if we have a discriminant greater than 0 and is a perfect square, then the nature of roots again are real, rational, and unequal. Let's take example number 3. Determine the nature of the roots of x squared plus 6x plus 3 equals 0. So we identify the values of a, b, and c, which are 1, 6, and 3 respectively. Now again, using the discriminant b squared minus 4ac, and we substitute these values of a, b, and c, we have 6 squared minus 4 times 1 times 3. Now we know that 6 squared is 36. And we also know that negative 4 times 1 times 3 is negative 12. Now again, subtracting 12 from 36 will give you 24. Now the discriminant is greater than 0. Diba? Mas malaki si 24 kaysa sa 0. And we know that 24 is not a perfect square. So we can describe the nature of the roots of x squared plus 6x plus 3 equals 0 as real, irrational, and unequal. So to show you kung bakit siya real, irrational, at unequal, so we'll use the discriminant, which is 24, and plug it in the quadratic formula. So to check, we know that x squared plus 6x plus 3 equals 0 cannot be factored. So we use the quadratic formula. So we know that our discriminant is 24. So we plug in the 24 inside the radicand. So we know that b is 6, so negative 6 plus or minus the square root of 24 all over 2. Now we see that there are two values of roots, two solutions. Ang isa, negative 6 plus the square root of 24 all over 2. Ang isa naman, negative 6 minus the square root of 24 all over 2. And we know that these values are unequal and at the same time, irrational. So again, if your discriminant is greater than 0 but not perfect square, the roots are real, irrational, and unequal. Let's take the last example. Determine the nature of the roots of x squared minus x plus 2 equals 0. So the same process will be applied. Identify the values of a, b, and c, and we know that it's 1, negative 1, and 2 respectively. So using the discriminant, b squared minus 4ac. So, substitute lang natin yung values ng a, b, and c. We'll have the negative 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times 2. Now, these values will give you 1 minus 8. Now, we see that the discriminant is equal to negative 7. We know that if the discriminant is less than 0, then the nature of roots are not real. Ibig sabihin, there's no solution to this quadratic equation. So, let's check. We know that x squared minus x plus 2 equals 0 cannot be factored. So, in this case, we will use the quadratic formula. Now, bakit natin sinabing no solution? So, using the quadratic formula, if we plug in negative 7 in the radicand, yung b squared minus 4ac, we will have this, negative 1 times the negative 1 plus or minus the square root of negative 7 all over 2. Now, as you can see, the radicand is negative. So, this will give you an imaginary number. So, hindi pwede. So, that's why there is no solution. Remember these four cases. If the discriminant b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots can be described as real, rational, and equal. If the discriminant is greater than 0 and a perfect square number, then the roots are real, rational, and unequal. Kapag naman ang discriminant ay greater than 0 pero hindi perfect square, ang roots ay real, irrational, and unequal. And lastly, if the discriminant is less than 0, then walang solution sa quadratic equation. Please pause the video and practice the math skills that you have learned. Don't forget to type your answers on the comments section. Kung may natutunan kayo sa tutorial na ito, huwag kalimutang i-like, share, at mag-subscribe sa aking YouTube channel. Tandaan, ang sikreto para maging mathusay, matuto, at mag-ensayo. Kita-kit sa susunod na aralin. Bye!